Amari Cooper, single high safety, or maybe no safety if it's a zero blitz. You know, we are taking our shot to a guy we traded first round pick for. But they're going to have to take those shots because they're in second and short because Zeke got him 8 yards on first down. Zeke has to be dominant. Like that is, and the Seahawks have been excellent in the last 6 weeks of football against the run particularly. Mm-hmm. This is going to have to be one of those situations where the other team knows what we're going to do, but we're going to do it anyway because Tyron Smith should be fresh.
Yes.
Zach Martin should be fresh. The offensive line should be as fresh and as good as it's been all year, should be the healthiest it's been all year, aside from Travis Frederick, obviously. Let's see if they can impose their will because that's the way they win this playoff game.
I've sat next to you for the last 6-7 weeks talking about the Cowboys, and not once have we had a segment where we just talk about how important Zeke is. We've talked about Dak. We've talked about that O-line. We've talked about the defense. Are we almost taking Zeke for granted? I mean, yes, he has to be perfect, but he's been that great. He's the one thing you can absolutely count on this Cowboys team. Is there any doubt going against Seattle that he won't be?
No, I don't have any doubt that Zeke won't have a good performance against the Seattle Seahawks. Now, what I am worried about is that Dallas Cowboys defensive front seven going up against that Seattle rushing attack. I mean, because Seattle is just gashing people. They're number one in rushing in the NFL for a reason. That zone scheme is hard to stop. And then, of course, you can't account for Russell Wilson when he goes off script and he's able to create with his legs. So I think that Dallas Cowboys defense is going to have to step up. I can't ignore the fact that they got gashed by the Indianapolis Colts back in week 15. Mm-hmm. I mean, they rung up over 170 yards rushing with Marlon Mack. Yeah. And so when you start talking about Chris Carson and that Seattle Seahawks run game, I think the Dallas Cowboys front seven has got their work cut out for them. So I think it's going to be important for the Dallas Cowboys offensively to sustain drives, to be good on third downs. And that's not necessarily something that they've been great against playoff caliber teams.
Sure.
So I think that's something that we have to keep an eye on. The Dallas Cowboys offense being able to help their defense out by sustaining drives and keeping those guys off the field.
The number one rush offense is playing in this game. It's not the team with Zeke. It's Seattle.
Yeah.
And what they've done since week four, 12 of 13 games, they've had at least 150 on the ground. They've averaged 177 on the ground at over 5 yards per carry. The Ravens have gotten a lot of attention as of late since Lamar was added to the lineup for being so run heavy. Seattle's been a lighter version of that all year long, which is interesting because in the previous few years, ever since Marshawn Lynch left, that had been their issue, was they couldn't establish a run. They couldn't run block, and they didn't have the personnel to do it. They thought they addressed it in the first round this year with Rashad Penny. He's been a healthy scratch most of the season. It's been Chris Carson who's been the bell cow for them. The Cowboys' front's going to have to be great, or else Seattle's going to have 12-play, 7-minute, 82-yard drives. They're going to have long drives that shorten the game, and Seattle feels great if it's a close game with Russell Wilson in the fourth quarter. Like, that is, there has been the recipe to get into the postseason. To get to your point, Jenna, one of the reasons that we have taken Zeke as a given is he's been a given.
Right.
Since he, at Ohio State, he was a given. His rookie year, he wins the rushing title. Last year, he rushes more yards per game than any player in the league. The only reason he doesn't win the rushing title is the suspension. This year, he's yards per game, the best in the league. Again, like Ezekiel Elliott is the best runner of the football in the NFL. And that's with a healthy or unhealthy offensive line.
But you know who isn't a given is his quarterback, Dak Prescott. You brought that up earlier. Before we go to break, talk a little bit about how much pressure is on Dak Prescott to pick up where Week 17 ended and a few games prior.
Well, there's going to be a lot of pressure on Dak Prescott just because he has not won a playoff game. I know 2 years ago they had the number one seed in the NFC and they lost in the divisional round to the Green Bay Packers. So even though they're at home again in the postseason, they're going up against a head coach and quarterback combination that you have to say you trust more than the Dallas Cowboys have in place right now with Jason Garrett and Dak Prescott. So, I mean, it's a situation where there's going to be some pressure. Dak is going to feel the intensity of the playoffs, especially in this particular matchup where everybody is saying that you have a team from a talent standpoint that should be able to take care of the Seattle Seahawks at home.
I hope someone told Dak this week to watch that playoff game against the Packers because he was extraordinary. That was the capstone of his amazing rookie season.
He was good in the second half of that
absolutely.
Game. Okay.
No, keep it in mind. Yeah. In the first half, the whole Cowboys offense
They had stalled. A double-digit deficit going into the second half.
Right, but that's kind of to my point. He was down double digits in a playoff game against Aaron Rodgers, and they were they were there at the end. It took a 50-plus yard curving field goal to beat him. He was so good in the second half of that game. Remind Dak, you can do this. I don't know that I believe it, but make him believe it. You can do this in the biggest game of your life. You went toe-to-toe with Aaron Rodgers, almost played him to a draw. That could maybe add to the confidence he built on in that Giants game last week.
All right, let's take a break. Coming up, could the Giants really move on from Odell Beckham? That's the rumor. Nobody loves a rumor more than I do. That's